Hello and welcome to Virtual Crafts. In this video we'll see how we can add variable products to our WooCommerce store. Some of the last videos were about how we can add simple products and downloadable products in our website. Now what variable products are, as the name depicts, is same as the simple product, but now you have added some variations to your product. For example, if I'm selling laptops on my WooCommerce store and I have, let's say, 10 units of the same laptop, but their specifications are different. For example, one of them has a hard drive of 500 GB while the other one has a hard drive of 1000 GBs. So obviously the prices of both of these variants will be different, and that's what we can achieve in an e-commerce store using variable products. More generally, let's go to shop page and let's see a variable product. Now this is a variable product. You'll see that its price is not fixed. It is starting from $19 and it ends at $29 because there are different prices for different variations. Now there are two variations in this case, the color and the size of the shirt. So let's choose the variant we require, and you'll see that the prices and the product will change accordingly. Let's say I want a large shirt and I want the color to be green. You'll see that the sale price is $24, but if I want the same green shirt in an extra large size, you'll see that now the price has been changed to $29. You can select your preferred variant from here, and after you've selected your specifications, simply choose the number of units you want to purchase of this item and click add to cart. And you'll see that this product has now been added to our cart, and we can go through the checkout process now. So this is the product we'll be adding in our stores in this video. So follow along and let's see how we can go through everything. I'll go to my dashboard. Okay, now I'm on my dashboard. As we have to add a new product, I'll go to the products tab. Here I do have some products, but all of these are simple products, as in this video we have to create a variable product. So I'll go to add new. Okay, the first thing I have to add here is the product name. As I'm adding a dress shirt as a variable product, I'll name it something like that. Okay, let's say this is the name of our product. The next thing I have to do is, just as any simple product, I have to add a description for this product. I'll go to Lorem Ipsum. And I'll copy some text from here and paste it back in the description text box. I'll scroll down, and this is where we choose the product type. Currently a simple product is selected. We have seen how we can add a simple product and a downloadable product in our previous videos. Here you'll have to select this option, variable product, and as soon as you select variable product from this drop down, you'll see this new tab, variations. When we go to simple product again, this tab is hidden. I'll change it to variable product again. Okay, in the inventory you can give an SKU number for your product. Let's say I give it the SKU number as shirt 123 or anything like this. You can choose if you have to manage the stock. I'll check it, and I'll add my stock quantity as, let's say, 50. I don't allow the back orders, and the lost stock threshold can be, let's say, 3. You can check this box if you want this product to be sold individually. Okay, now let's go and add our product variations. I'll click this tab, and you'll see that before adding variations, we have to create some custom attributes. So I'll go to the attributes tab, and I'll have to create some attributes here that I want to be variable. I'll click add. And here I'll add the first attribute as color. Here I'll have to write all the attributes that I want to be variable in this product, separated by this vertical line. So I'll add the colors here: red, blue, and green. Okay, now you have to check this checkbox, used for variations. And now this attribute color will be used for variations. I'll click save attribute, and you'll see that our first attribute has been created. Now I'll add another attribute for size. I'll click add, and I'll name this one size, and the values for this attribute are medium, large, and extra large. You can add these values according to you. I'll check this checkbox again, used for variations, and I'll save this attribute. Okay, now I have created the attributes. Now I'll go to variations tab, and you'll see that the warning message we saw earlier is now gone. Here you have two options. You can add variations one by one yourself, or you can choose this option, create variations from all attributes. I'll choose this one and click go. Now I'll see a warning message that this will create all the combinations possible for the attributes we created. I'll click OK. And you'll see that I have 9 variations added. The first color with all the 3 sizes, the second color with all the 3 sizes, and the third color with all the 3 sizes. So that makes total of 9 combinations. Now we have to add the prices and images for all the variations. I'll expand the first variation. And here you can choose if this variation is enabled or not. If I uncheck this checkbox, this variation will no longer be enabled. I'll recheck it. Here I'll add the price for this variation. Let's say $20. You can choose if you want to manage the stock for this variation. I'll let it go for now. You can add a sale price as well. Here you'll choose the weight of the product, which is not mandatory, but you can choose it anyway. So let's say this weighs 0.3 kg. You can add the dimensions, length, width and height. I'll leave this part. Here you can choose the shipping class for this variation. You'll see all the shipping classes you created in this drop down. Here you can add the description for this particular variation. I'll leave it empty. Okay, now I'll add the image for this variation. This is a red medium. I'll upload the files. As this variation is for the red shirt, I'll choose this one and then click set variation image. And you'll see that the image has been set. When you'll hover over it, you'll see this cross icon. When you click it, this image will be removed and you'll be able to upload a new image. I'll collapse this variation. I'll go to the next one. I'll add a price, a sale price. I'll upload the image for this one. Red again. Rest of the fields are not mandatory, so I'll skip them. Now same for the third variation. I'll choose the image. Set the price. And I'll collapse it again. The next one. This time the blue shirt will be selected. The price for medium is again 20. Okay, I've added the content for all the variations. I'll click save changes. Now all of these variations have been saved. Here I have to write a short description of the product. So I'll paste the one I copied earlier. And let's shorten it. I'll have to select the product image. So I'll click this link, set product image. And let's say I want the default image for the product to be this one. I'll set it as the product image. Here I'll choose the product gallery, which will be all of these three images, and I'll add them to gallery. I'll scroll up again. Here I'll create a new category, shirts, and I'll click add new category. So this will be the category for this product. You can play with these settings according to you. I'll publish this product. Okay, the product has now been published. It can be seen on the shop page. I'll preview it from here. And you'll see the product here. This is the title that we specified. This is the breadcrumb, the name of the product, the category and the page, the prices, the short description. And here are the two variations we added. Let's choose a size, medium. And now let's variate the color of the shirt, which will be red, blue or green. You'll see that the prices for each variation are different. Let me select extra large from here and you'll see $29, and for medium it will be $19. You'll see the current stock here. Here you can choose the number of units you want to purchase of this product and then click add to cart to add this product to the cart. So that's how you can add variable products to your WooCommerce store. That's all for this video. If you like the video, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon next to it to receive the notifications of every new video uploaded. Thank you and see you in the next video.